Welcome back, scientists. It's Justin again. Have you ever looked at the moon? I mean, looked at it really closely? People all around the world have looked up at the moon and imagined different shapes on the moon's surface. Some see a rabbit. Others picture a person carrying wood, or the famous man in the moon. To explain these shapes, many cultures created stories that were passed down for thousands of years. But here's the interesting part. Those pictures people imagine? They're based on the real shapes and colors we do see on the moon's surface. So, what secrets do those features hold about the moon's past? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain what exactly makes a space object a moon, and describe at least three features found on the surface of our moon. Let's investigate! Easy to spot the moon. It's one of the biggest, brightest things in the night sky. But the moon isn't just sitting still up there, it's constantly orbiting Earth. That makes the moon something called a satellite. A satellite is any object that moves around a planet in space. There are actually lots of satellites orbiting Earth. Some were built by people and sent into space on rockets. These human-made satellites help us do all kinds of things, like take pictures of Earth, predict the weather, or even help with phone calls and TV signals. But while Earth has a lot of satellites, it only has one moon. So what's the difference between the moon and those other satellites? Well, humans didn't build the moon, and no one sent it into space. A moon is a natural object that revolves around a planet. There are over 200 moons in our solar system, and they come in all sorts of shapes and sizes. Some are made of solid rock, others are covered in thick layers of ice. Some even have oceans buried deep beneath their surfaces. Moons can be big or small, smooth or covered in craters. Earth only has one moon, but other planets have dozens. Our moon isn't the biggest or the most unusual in the solar system, but it does stand out for a different reason. Most moons are much smaller than the planets they orbit. But Earth's moon is about 1/4 the size of Earth. And since it's so close, we can see a lot of details on its surface with just our eyes. So what causes those dark and light spots we see on the moon? The moon might look smooth and glowing from far away, but up close, it's a dusty, rocky place. Its surface is covered with loose material that's been broken down over time by impacts from space rocks. If you could explore different parts of the moon, you'd notice some big differences depending on where you land. Take a second to look at this image of the moon. What do you notice? Pause the video and jot down what you see in your guided notes. You might have spotted dark circles, bright patches, or rough, bumpy areas. So what are those dark and light areas really? First, any of these bright, lumpy areas like this one on the moon's surface are called highlands. The highlands are made of hard, jagged rocks. The highlands are the oldest parts of the moon's surface. For billions of years, space rocks crashed into the moon again and again. These impacts broke up the rock and left behind lots of bumps, cracks, and holes. That's why the highlands look rough and uneven. They've been hit so many times that they're full of sharp edges and high rocky hills. But space rocks didn't just break up the surface of the moon, they also left behind something else. Look at all the round holes. These are called craters. Craters are round holes or dents in an object's surface. They were made when space rocks crashed into the moon a long time ago. When a space rock hits the surface, it makes a big explosion. Rock and dust go flying in every direction. Some craters are small, but others are huge, as wide as a city. You can even see some of the biggest craters from Earth with just your eyes. Why do you think the moon has so many marks from space rocks, way more than we see on Earth? Here's a clue. The moon doesn't have much of an atmosphere to protect it. Earth's atmosphere helps burn up space rocks before they ever reach the ground. But on the moon, there's no thick blanket of air to stop them. That's why space rocks hit the moon's surface again and again, and why those impacts play a big role in shaping what we see. And here's something cool. Because the moon doesn't have weather like Earth, these craters don't wear away. That means many of them have stayed just the way they were when they first formed, for billions of years. So far, we've seen the moon's oldest, roughest highlands, and the craters left behind by powerful impacts. But not every part of the moon looks like that. Take a look at the large, dark, flat areas on the moon's surface. Those are called maria. From far away, maria look like dark spots or stains, but they're actually huge plains made of smooth, cooled lava. A long time ago, giant space rocks hit the moon with so much force that they made deep cracks in the surface. Hot, melted rock from inside the moon came bubbling out. It spread across the ground and eventually cooled and hardened into flat, dark rock. That's why maria look different from the highlands and craters. They're smoother, darker, and lower than the land around them. You won't find sharp hills or deep holes here, just wide, flat plains that stretch for miles. Think you're a moon expert now? Here's a picture of the moon's surface that shows all three features: highlands, craters, and maria. Can you figure out which is which? Pause the video and see if you can label the diagram in your guided notes. This bright, rocky area is the highlands. The round dents are craters, and the dark, flat areas are the maria. Let's review everything we've learned today. We learned that a moon is a natural object that orbits a planet. Our moon orbits Earth, and it's one of the easiest things to spot in the night sky. We then talked about three of our moon's coolest features: the highlands, the craters, and the maria. To learn more about the moon, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, the next time you look up at the moon, those dark and light spots won't be a mystery anymore. You'll know exactly what caused them. But, still totally looks like a rabbit to me. Keep exploring, scientists! There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time!